My name is Helen Chang. I'm from Seoul, Korea, and I came to America in 1972. I live in America almost 50 years. So I'm more American than Korean, but I'm very proud to be Korean American. I don't remember the war. I was born in 1949 and war started at 50, so I was very young. My parents came from north to south before the war, and they lost everything and they made something, and they were just settling in Seoul. Then Korean War broke. So they went down, they had nothing again, and my mother didn't have money, but she sent me to private institution for me to learn English conversation. And I always wanted to learn English. First grade of middle school, and I learned something in English, and I want to practice, so I will go to the UN cemetery. They always had the UN people guarding, so I'll go there and say, "What time is it? Hello, how are you?" And I practice every day same language. So many people moved from Seoul to Busan. That was the only place they can stay, and it was very crowded. And people who came to South, they didn't have a house or food or a place to even stay. So it was a very sad situation. And they had a horrible typhoon came. It was day of the Chuseok. And all I remember was every food, every house, everybody was on the water. It was very, very terrible typhoon. Lots of people died. But when I came back to Seoul, Korea, it was 1968 to go to college. And that time in Korea, it's very hard to entrance exam. And I failed. My friends all got into Ewha Women's University. So I was passing by hotel called, that time was the only hotel, Joseon Hotel. And they were having big sign, "We are looking for somebody who can be a receptionist for the hotel, for the VIPs who can speak English." So I just went in, interviewed, and I got the job. That time, the Joseon Hotel was the only hotel in Korea, and all the movie stars, all the high jebol, the expensive place, and we had President Park Jung-hee coming there. It was the only club called Galaxy Club in 69. That was the biggest thing in Korea. And they gave me so much tip. I made about 3 times more than my salary. I was just making more money than most doctors, you know, at 19. So I was really having a good time. And I stayed in the hotel I worked there for 2 years. And I met my first husband, who is from German. And he was the executive chef. So we got married 2.5 years later, and we went to Germany, and I immigrated to Las Vegas, Nevada, because my first husband got a job in Las Vegas, Nevada. And I couldn't speak German. We both spoke English, so we came to America in 1972 from Germany. So coming from Seoul, Korea to Las Vegas, Nevada, this was shocking. At that time in Las Vegas, there was 9 Korean people. And there was no Korean grocery store. So 9 people got together, and we didn't have any Korean food, but some of them had the gochujang. So we'll eat with celery with the gochujang and cabbage with the gochujang. And I never cooked in Korea, and I wanted the kimchi. And all I remember was it has to be fermented. So I left in the jar outside the patio in Las Vegas sun. It bloated everywhere. I almost could cry. The smell was horrible. It was really culture shock from Korea to Las Vegas. But I started outright. My husband got transferred to Texas. So I came to Dallas, and there were like 5,000 Koreans. So it was a big city, and I was so happy to see some Koreans, and I met a few people, and we made a group. You know, we met once a week for lunch, and so I lived in Dallas, Texas for 5 years, and I moved to Houston. In Dallas, I got divorced. I came to Houston single. That time I adopted my niece, So I brought her and myself to Dallas and started a new life. My sister had one child and her husband, they were divorced. And that time in Korea, it's very difficult for a single woman to raise a child. And I loved her, so I adopted her to bring to America. My first husband couldn't have children. That was one of the reasons I got divorced. And about 5 years later, I met my late husband, and he invested in me. He thought I was a good business person. And I worked very hard, like three jobs, trying to get a small condo, and I did. So I did like seven restaurants in office buildings, and I was going around and trying to make living, and I was very successful. Then we got married in 1 year later, and he adopted my daughter, who I adopted. She was my niece, and my husband was working with Wall Street, and we traveled a lot. And when she graduated, my daughter, they sent her to Wall Street, and she's still working in Wall Street the last 30 years. So when we failed, he had a bankrupt when he was 65, and I came from a ski trip, $40,000 ski trip of whole month, came back home, and he say, our company going down. I said, what? So I came from heaven to down the ground in 40 seconds, you know? But so we had a really hard time in financially that time. We had to pay so much back tax, and which they allowed the tax and they didn't allow it. So we had to pay back $4 million, which I didn't have it. And it was very difficult, and I had to go to work, and he couldn't get a job at his age. And I started from very scratch, and I sold my beautiful 10 carat diamond ring to trying to have business in wholesale district. And I went to China by the container, two container of tennis shoes came and sold here. My husband always made me feel, you really can do anything you want, and you're doing very, very well. He gave me such a big power that I can really do, even though I'm really not that level, but he put me up in the level. He made me feel, believe I can become that person. I became American citizen 45 years ago. And about 10 years ago, the Korea changed law. If you are more than 65 years old, you can have Korean citizen back. So it's dual Korean citizenship and American citizenship. I'm a, you know, natural Texan now. I lived in Texas for 45 years. I love Texas because, first of all, I lived here long, but people are very kind and generous. And in Texas, it's everything is so big and such opportunity. When I went to get a visa for my niece, who is my daughter now, and I went to American Embassy in Korea, it's very, very difficult to get a visa at that time to come to America. And it was 1975 she came here, and I went into the embassy, and there was an American counselor, and I'm trying to make it easy to get a stamp. All you need is a stamp to come to America. So I said, howdy. I said, I'm Miss KoTex. They said, what? I said, I'm Korean-Texan, I'm KoTex. So they were laughing, and there was no problem. I got a stamp right away. So my father could come here after my mother died. So I had my father in America for 25 years, and he got the visa easily. My niece, who is my adopted daughter, she came here easily. And I think everything is how you break the ice first, very funny. I think sense of humor, it makes life so much easier. Lately, what I'm proud is that I was the chairperson of sister city between Houston and Ulsan, and it got succeeded in 7 years. We just had official signing ceremony. We are exchanging the education, the economy, culture, So they sent the 1, 2 years, 3 years ago in Korean festival in Houston, the Ulsan, before even we become a sister city, they sent 55 people for all the art performance and cost them $100,000. But we gave in Houston, you know, Houstonians, Korean culture, everything. It was very successful. And then when we had COVID first 2 years ago, and we all were short of mask, and we asked the Ulsan city, and they sent $50,000 worth of mask to Houston city. Then I'm asking Houston city if they can give us a piece of land in that park in Koreatown so we can build a symbol of Korea, the nice gazebo at entrance of Koreatown. That will be very nice. So that's my next project. I think language is most important if you want to go to some other countries. Right now, I'm involved with the Korean school in Houston because our children who is born here, they have to learn Korean to communicate with their older parents. And it is very important to learn the language of your root. What makes me happy is that I wasn't college educated in Korea, but I learned and trained myself in this country. And I became what I am, which is impossible in Korea in my age. But in this country, age doesn't matter and education doesn't matter. How you self-educate yourself, you can become who you are if you work hard. And I feel like I'm very blessed that I made my American dream come true because I am respected from friends. I have lots of friends and I still can serve to Korean community and I can still serve to American community. I'm very, very happy. That's only possible in America, not in Korea at my age. My name is Helen Chang. This is my Korean American story.